This week on Maker Update, a turtle that writes, turning plastic into gold, electronic origami, and profiling your printer filament. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, our show collecting the coolest DIY projects and useful maker tips from across the internet. I hope you're doing well. We've got a great show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. From Niklas Roy, check out this compact 3D printed robot plotter. Like so much of his work, this project strikes a perfect balance between art and technology. It's playful, it's scrappy, and it's super open to remixing and reinterpretation. But unlike his other projects, such as the generative art machine or the Graphimat graffiti plotter, this little guy is absolutely something you can make in a weekend. In fact, there's a good chance that most of the components are already in your collection. He's using an Arduino Nano, two inexpensive 5-volt stepper motors, a Darlington driver to get them moving, a cheap hobby servo to move the pen up and down, and a couple of limit switches to help the robot detect and avoid obstacles. Throw in a pen and a battery and you're off to the races. Bear in mind though, it's a very slow race. Most of the footage here is sped up significantly. But that's kind of the endearing part of this. It's like a pet turtle that leaves messages on your floor instead of poop. And the turtle analogy is not coincidental. On his site, niklasroy.com, he shares some of the history of the educational logo programming language many children of the 80s like myself learned in school. Basically, you had this drawing cursor called a turtle, and you'd use lines of code to direct the turtle around the screen and draw a design. What I didn't know is that during the 70s and 80s, real robot manifestations of these turtles were made by MIT that kids could program and draw with using the same logo commands. Now, you can't program this robot using logo, though I suspect it wouldn't be that hard to adapt this to accept MakeCode or Scratch-style visual programming instructions as a modern-day alternative. In the code Niklas provides, there's a Hello World example to get you started, along with some commented out options for drawing a fish or a square. Even better, Niklas made an online tool for drawing your own design and translating it into vectors and code you can copy over to your Arduino. It's worth noting that he got a version of this working that writes out Asimov's three laws of robotics. That alone seems like reason enough to give this a shot. It's a great project, a quick build, and a fun payoff. The documentation is outstanding, with schematics, CAD files, code, an assembly video, bill of materials, everything you need. You can find a link down in the description. More projects. We've got another incredible cosplay helmet design from Zibartas, this time inspired by a character from Rainbow Six Siege. There's a neat dual servo mechanism for raising and lowering the faceplate, along with some beautifully executed color LED effects, but the real technical challenge for this design wasn't mechanical or electrical, but chemical. The gold finish used throughout the helmet is achieved using real gold electroplated to the 3D printed plastic. As a finish, electroplating is about as close as you can get to magic, but it definitely seems like a tricky process to master even for a pro like Zibartas. For example, to arrive at a gold finish, he first had to coat the parts in a conductive graphite paint. He then had to give it an electrical bath with some copper to establish a primary metal layer that he could polish and buff out. But before he could get to a gold finish, he had to repeat the process with a nickel coating and then give it another polish. Then the nickel has to be cleaned and activated for the gold finish to stick right. And finally, real 24 karat gold is plated onto the nickel using an electrically charged sponge instead of an electrolyte bath. The result is gorgeous, and there's just something about knowing the finish is real gold that just makes the whole thing feel elevated. Check out the video to see the magic for yourself. He also links out to makers like Hendrik and Alex Lab, who have many videos exploring the process of electroplating 3D printed designs. For a beautiful project that doesn't take weeks of polishing and chemicals, check out Erin St. Blaine's latest guide on Adafruit. She calls this the glowing lotus flower, and it's a fusion of LEDs, origami, and iridescent vinyl. By design, the electronics here are super straightforward and perfect for beginners. She's using an Adafruit Circuit Playground board, which combines a microcontroller, addressable LEDs, alligator clip friendly IO pins, and a live poly battery connection. The real trick here is creating the flower. She's using a desktop CNC vinyl cutter to crank out the pedals, 12 large ones, 12 small ones, and the center. Check out the project page to see how it all comes together. Now for some tips and tools. One of my favorite tips this week comes from Teaching Tech, who shows how to calibrate and adjust for how different types of filaments shrink after being 3D printed. All 3D printed objects are prone to some degree of shrinkage once they cool down. And as you may already know, some formulations of filament are more or less prone to this effect. Usually, you'll notice this problem when you design a hole with an exact diameter meant for a specific size of bolt, and what comes off the printer is too small to work. One fix is to scale the whole model up just a tick to compensate, but the real smart way to address the problem long term is to create a profile for your filament that accounts for its particular shrinkage qualities. I'm embarrassed to admit that I didn't even know this was possible. This video from Teaching Tech shows exactly how to calibrate and edit these settings using different slicer options. Through the Adafruit blog, I learned about a new Arduino library for creating expressive robot eye animations on small, common OLED screens. This one is called IrisOLED. It seems like a bit of a mashup of similar libraries we've seen from Flux Garage and Playful Technology, all of which are a riff on the cute robot eyes from Anki's Cosmo robot. It looks like the IrisOLED library throws in a few extra icons like battery life. Your mileage may vary, but it could be just the tool you're looking for. And from Jenny List on Hackaday, a great tip on how to sidestep the need for complicated brass insert strategies on your 3D prints by using and designing for self-tapping screws. From a design standpoint, the trick is to have a larger hole on the top piece and a smaller hole on the piece you're fixing it to. That way, there's more material for the screw to cut its threads into. The downside is that these threads won't be able to hold up to repeated use the same way an insert would. But for most projects where the expectation is to screw it together once, this seems like a more direct way to get things done. Worth adding to your toolbox for sure. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, you absolutely have to check out Becky Stern's latest video on benchtop power supplies. I have to admit, when I was first starting out, I made do by powering my projects with a collection of old wall warts, and it was dicey. Not only are adjustable benchtop power supplies more affordable than ever, but they can help you work faster and better determine the ideal voltage and current needs of your next project. Becky's video does a great job walking you through the basics and demonstrates a few techniques to help you determine your project's power needs. Check it out. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment if you can. A big thanks as always to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.